people in the office.
I'm Darryl Bryant with YVTV, and I'm in Moxville, North Carolina with Kyle Swisegood, a young man that I just met Saturday at a World War II veterans event that he's been very much involved in. And we came by today to kind of find out how it came to be and to find out a little more about what Kyle's been involved in. Kyle, it's good to see you.
Likewise, good seeing you. I'm glad you're able to come today.
Tell me, obviously the event Saturday, I was over the top impressed. And was over top impressed with what you've been able to accomplish down here with that. How did that come to be?
The Triad Flight of Honor is really the roots of the local veterans luncheon that we have here in Davie County. The first flight that I took to Washington, which was in the spring of 2010, I was speaking to one of the veterans on the way to the airport. And he was sharing with me his incredible experience in World War II. And I thought to myself, I need to get this recorded. I need to memorialize this experience that this gentleman has gone through. So what we did is I actually got a camera, and we began making recordings of all of these veteran stories, up to 21 hours worth.
Oh, man.
And then I thought, you know, these guys are in the autumn of their life. We need to have a World War II reunion. So last fall, with the help of Dino's, a great place to eat barbecue in downtown Moxville, we decided to invite them all on a Saturday morning to come and have a barbecue sandwich. And it was an experience I'll never forget.
What a great idea. What a great idea. And the event that you just had, that was the second annual then?
That was. And we had actually more this go-round than we had the first go-round. I'm saddened by the fact that three of the veterans that came to the first luncheon passed away. And that's an interesting thing about this generation. These guys are dying. Mm-hmm. And they're dying at a rate of about 2,500 a week, World War II veterans.
Right.
And in the twilight of their life, I find it very important to raise these guys up, elevate them to the hero status that they are. They saved the world.
They really did. I know there was a moment of nostalgia for me as I was watching these guys. One gentleman who was there said he was in North Africa and he was in Italy and Sicily. And he was basically in the same place as my dad was in World War II. So I had that feeling, too, of, man, I wish my dad could be here for this. Mm-hmm. He's been gone a while now, but I can't tell you how important a thing and how good a thing that I think you're doing with that. And it was obvious on the faces of these veterans that they really appreciated it. I think they appreciated the attention.
Mm-hmm.
And it was neat to see the instant camaraderie that they had as they broke off into groups of sharing with amongst each other as well as sharing with us.
It has been an incredibly rewarding thing for me. And there's a few other folks involved with the Rotary Club who have come and have helped me with this event. This past event, I want to give thanks to John Woodard at Woodard & Company over in Bermuda Run. He helped finance this past event. And what you see when we have these things is you're exactly right. We've got fellows that came from the country. They came from the farms. They had not been very far from home. And our country called them, and they answered the call without complaining. I hear over and over again the comments from these veterans. They say they did what they had to do.
Right.
And just this past Saturday at this event, we had a Pearl Harbor veteran. We had a Normandy, Omaha Beach veteran. Right. We had multiple Purple Heart veterans. We had Harold Frank. Harold was a POW for 9 months, lived on potato soup in Germany.
Very moving
it was.
Story that he shared with us.
It was. We've got Craig Haynes. Craig was on a ship. He left, I believe it's San Francisco. And when he was in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, he was about 18 or 19 years old. His ship was hit with a torpedo. The ship sank, and he was left hanging onto debris for almost 24 hours in the Pacific Ocean. Now, I'm going to tell you, why do I get together with these veterans. Number one, I want to know their story. Right. But I videotape these veterans because I want my children and my children's children to realize that freedom is not free. And I want to thank every one of these guys. Every time we have these events, I thank them for their service to our country.
Well, one of the things I noticed too, and you could see the guys almost blush when we use that phrase hero. I think that's one of the things about that generation was that extreme level of modesty. He said, "Oh, I'm not a hero," and you're aware of their story that everything indicates yes, and yes, you are a hero.
I serve on the Triad Flight of Honor. I've been a flight director, a guardian, and a team leader on multiple flights. And on every one of those flights, we have about 100 veterans that we take up to the memorial. And you're exactly right. There's no veteran that stands up and beats his chest about his service. They are the most humble people that I've ever been around. And that's a lesson.
Yeah.
That's a lesson that I want to learn about. I see their humility, and they served our country, and they're not asking for big flags to be waved about them. In fact, the World War II Memorial was dedicated, I believe, in 2004. Mm. Now, you realize 1945 is when the war ended.
They waited a long time for that memorial.
They didn't go put their own memorial up. They waited, and it was finally built. Bob Dole had a big hand in it, but it is it's a moving day when we take those guys up there to see their memorial. I can tell you that I've done it about four or five times now. There's not a moment that I don't walk down into the belly of the memorial and have to keep my emotions in check, because I'm seeing these guys who are probably looking at that memorial for the last time, a lot of them.
You've got two or three powerful experiences going on at one time. Then.
Yeah.
Well, as a citizen of the area and with YVTV and representing Yadtail, we sincerely appreciate your efforts on that. It's I don't think you could have any more worthy recipients of it. And we thank you for putting a spotlight on that and for what you do with it.
Absolutely.
Ever so much.
You bet. Happy to do it. I'm glad you came.